Hey everybody, welcome back to Live on Stage. I am your host, Lucio Fernandez. Bienvenidos a En Vivo y En Escena conmigo, Lucio Fernandez. Soy su anfitrión aquí en este programa de televisión fenomenal. Tonight, I don't feel like talking too much because the producer, director doesn't want me to talk, so I'm a little incognito. So we're just gonna get on with the show, ladies and gentlemen. Just go on with the show. Si no voy a hablar mucho porque la directora me tiene cuestionado aquí en vivo y en escena conmigo, Lucio Fernandez. Así que we're not gonna talk. We're gonna go right to the show. And we have a great show. We have Mary Aldousary. We have Megan Fernandez. We have Amy Smith. We have Larry Piscitelli in New York City on Times Square. So enough talking. Para la bobería, vamos a chequear, vamos para Times Square a ver a Larry bailarín principal de TapOle, y a Megan Fernandez, y a Amy Smith, y a Mary Aldousary. We're going. Check this out, people. We'll check this out. I can't see you. Check this out. Come back to me later. Peace out, baby.
We're here at Times Square with the one and only majestic dancer of the TapOle Dance Company, Lorenzo Piscitelli. Larry, how are you?
Good. Hi guys, how you doing?
We're here in Times Square, Lorenzo's neighborhood. Tell us, show us where you live, Larry.
I live right there, straight ahead to the right.
Straight ahead and to the right in Times Square, right here, ladies and gentlemen, right here. And tell us, Larry, what brings you to New York City?
Well, today I'm actually here with my friends, and we are doing, well, we did a photo shoot for a new show coming up with my friend Lucio Fernandez, Less Cuban Than Ever. So we did a photo shoot today for publicity, and it was really, really fun. Hopefully all of you guys come.
And Larry, how long have you been dancing?
I have been dancing for 13 years. I am from Connecticut. And I started when I was 12. I started late, but for a boy, that's kind of early. And I've been living in New York for 13 years now, dancing professionally. Just traveled all over and now brought me here, and I love it.
And we're here, you're taking a trip to Ecuador. Members of the TapOle Dance Company, Ecuador.
I am going to Ecuador in August, and I am so excited. I love to travel, and to go to a different country is gonna be amazing, and I'm so excited to perform and work and get to see stuff. It's gonna be a lot of fun.
And what kind of dancing do you do, Larry?
I do everything, tap, jazz, lyrical, ballet, musical theater, a little bit of ballroom, a little bit of Latin, tap. I try to do a little bit of everything.
And how long have you been with the TapOle Dance Company?
I've been with TapOle for about 3 years now.
Wow, and do you love it? Do you like it?
I love it, it's so much fun. The cast is great, the director's great, the choreographer's great, the people are great. It's so much fun, we get to perform outside, we get to perform in New Jersey, in New York, everywhere. We get to do a lot of things all over the place. We get to do parades, benefits, galas, so much stuff. It's a lot of fun.
And tell us, Larry, you also performed at the world famous Carnegie Hall. What was that about?
That was amazing. That's probably the biggest highlight so far of my life. Other than dancing in Europe, Carnegie Hall was amazing. I mean, to be in the dressing room where you're sitting down and you look to your right and it's like Judy Garland, Liza Minnelli, and then you look to your left and it's like Robin Williams and Al Pacino and Broadway greats. It was amazing. It was an absolute experience that I'll never forget.
Well, tell us about any other experience. You've like, you also done some cruise ships?
I've done two cruise ships. I've done a cruise ship in 2000 called the Costa Classica. We traveled all over Europe, Italy and Greece and Mykonos, Santorini. I did that for 6 months. And then my second ship was about 4 years ago, and I was in Hawaii. I'm the pride of America for Norwegian Cruise Lines. That was very fun as well.
Now, Larry, tell us, what does it feel like to be a dancer living in New York City, the capital of the world, capital of the arts of the world?
It is, I don't do drugs, but it is like a high, if I was to say that. I mean, to be here, as you can see, like, look at my backdrop. Can we take a moment? Look at my backdrop. Now that is where I live. You thought you were in a movie, weren't you? Yes, no, that's my backyard, actually. So it is so much fun. I mean, my dream when I was little was to live in New York. I would cut out my room at home. I would have framed black and white pictures of New York all over my room. And one day I'm like, I'm gonna live there. And yeah, I've been here for 13 years now and I love it. The hustle and bustle is crazy. And sometimes you cry, sometimes you laugh, but that's what makes you a performer. And I love it. I'm very lucky, actually.
And what does the future hold for you, Larry?
Well, I'm still auditioning. I teach, I choreograph, I perform with TapOle, and I just hope to keep on performing as long as I can. It's the only thing that I love to do and the only thing I really want to do. So I'm just going to do it as much as I can. Until my body tells me I can't, I'm going to be kicking and dancing.
And in the fall, you're going to be playing in New York City on
42nd Street. And in the fall, on 42nd Street, I'm going to be at the Laurie Beachman Theater performing in the new show, Less Cuban Than Ever, starring Lucio Fernandez and his full-piece orchestra, amazing dancers, in New York for four performances in October. So hopefully everybody can come and check it out. It's going to be a blast.
Anything else you want to tell us, Larry?
I just want to say enjoy and live and love, and hopefully everybody can come to New York and experience what I experience every single day.
So should we check out Times Square?
Come to Times Square and check it out. Like I said, this is my backdrop in my life.
And what else, Larry? Anything else?
No, I think that's it. Also, come to the show in October.
Peace out, Larry.
Peace out. Thank you so much, guys.
Let's check out Times Square, then we'll check out a clip. Lorenzo dancing. Well, we're back here on Times Square with the three members of TapOle. We have Megan Fernandez, the director. Woo! We have Larry Piscitelli and Amy Smith right here. Megan, so tell us a little bit about TapOle. When did it begin? What do you guys do?
Wow, TapOle, I began, I believe, in 2005, and we've been getting bigger and better ever since then. And we do a little bit of everything. TapOle, so obviously we do tap, but we do a little bit of jazz, modern, musical theater, Latin. We mix it all up and make it fun and interesting and entertaining.
Entertaining it is. We just saw a clip of you guys dancing. That was a great demo that we saw. And next we're going to see you and Larry performing with the Cuban Kid. Amy was featuring the video too back there. You know, she couldn't make the next video because she was otherwise engaged. But
She's a busy girl.
Y'all so busy.
And you guys are traveling all over the place. Megan, will tell us about some of your plans. I think Larry told us all, but...
Well, yeah, I think Larry mentioned already, but we have plans. Some of us are going to be traveling to Ecuador with the famous Cuban kids. So we're going to be going to Ecuador. We're really excited about that, and we're preparing now. So that's scheduled for August. So that's a pretty exciting one for us.
And a side note, www.tapoledancecompany.com.
That's a nice plug.
Little commercial, you know.
Little commercial.
Check us out.
And what brings you kids to Times Square today?
We were doing actually a photo shoot today. So we were, you know.
we're dressed up and ready to go for a new show in October.
Yeah, we're a Cuban kid.
Were you kids all in feathers?
Yes. Some of us were.
I wasn't in feathers. I wanted to be in feathers, but I wasn't allowed. No, I'm joking.
How come you didn't let him get into feathers?
Well, he tried to take my costume, and, you know, I would have preferred being in his costume.
That's a separate photo shoot.
Hey, excuse me, we're taping here.
That's a different show, you know. We're not working on that show yet.
So, Larry, anything else to say?
No, just check us out. Check us out, our show in October. Check us out the website, www.TapOleDanceCompany.com.
We're performing all over this summer, indoors and out, so check us out. Our schedule's on the website, and we're performing all over.
Like the director said, we do all kinds of dancing, all kinds of styles, so it's good for everybody. It's good for kids, adults, older, younger. We do a little bit for everything, and it's very, very entertaining.
I really wish.
And Ms. Smith, what's your specialty? I hear you do a mean tap number.
I do. I enjoy tap. She's our featured tapper of the company. Yeah, she's excellent. She, you know, choreography. Plus, she's always a featured soloist.
And what does she feature in? Modern, tap, ballet.
Well, she features in a little bit of everything. She does it all.
She does it all. Is that true, Miss Smith?
I try to do everything.
She's good at everything.
She is, Larry.
She's very good at everything.
Well, thank you, kids. Well, should we go check out that one little piece where you guys perform with that one guy that we all know and love? What do you guys think?
Check it out.
Check it out,
people. See you guys soon.
Peace out.
Look for us around town.
Hit it, Roberto.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Live on Stage. We have here in the studio the one and only, the beautiful vocalist,
Mary Aldousary. I hope I'm pronouncing your name right, because, you know, Hispanics have a tendency to mumble. Not all Hispanics, but especially me. But Mary, tell us a little bit about yourself, what you do, why you have long hair.
It's my look at this point. Hi, thank you so much for having me. I am honored to be here. I live in New York City now. I'm originally from Chicago. I did musical theater out there, and I studied voice. I'm classically trained, so I studied opera first, and then quit that and decided I wanted to be opera. Mm-hmm. And I was like, no, I want to be a jazz singer. So I quit everything and became a jazz singer instead. Thank God, knock on wood, I did a lot of work, mostly plays, surprisingly. Even though I'm classically trained as a singer, I did a lot of plays in Chicago. But my dream is to move to New York. And eventually I did. I moved to New York, went to AMDA, the American Musical and Dramatic Academy, and I was blessed to work with the people there. I had the most amazing mentors, and I think every actor at any age should always have a mentor. And so I've been here ever since. I mean, it's only been 6 years, but I've been working here as a singer. I'm currently working on a workshop right now, too. And yeah, so reason why I have long hair, it's cheaper. Yeah, much cheaper.
Now, tell us a little bit about your background, your family. Any members of your family, were they artists, were they performers?
My mom was a movie star in the Philippines. She was gorgeous. She started off as a model, and she was a big movie star growing up. She used to lie Filipinos. I remember my piano teacher. My piano teacher said, "Are you sure your name is Diana? You really look like this movie star before in the Philippines. Her name is Jane Palomar." Well, she went by, to everyone else, it was Diana Palomar. But yeah, she was at that point where she had to become incognito. And even going to the Philippines recently, I had to have a bodyguard. Yeah, so she actually didn't want me to go into the theater. But with her status back there, I don't know why, but she thought in America, theater and TV and film, she had this assumption that it was full of drugs and everything bad, so she didn't let me. Yeah, I had to be the black sheep, and no, it's true. So she didn't want me to get into it for a very long time. She was very strict.
Now, you were born in Chicago?
I was born and raised in Chicago, yes.
Brothers and sisters, other performers?
No, they should be. My sister lives in L.A. She is gorgeous, so she is the type of person who walked in with her roommate to the Academy Awards, and so many agents came up to her and tried to sign her. But no, not a performer. She's very artistic in many ways, but no, brother, both of them are older, and he's a businessman. Yeah, I'm the only one who all the way through wanted to become an artist.
Now tell us about some of the plays you've been in, some of the shows you've been in, some of the musicals, what you look towards the future.
Well, the future, I just want to be a steady actor who doesn't have a day job. You know, isn't that what we work for here? But I've done my first big role, not quite big, but I played a tap dancing triceratops for 2 years. Yeah, and honestly, it was a theater company that took teenagers and also took teenage performers and teenage artists, and also incorporated kids who didn't have access to the arts and merged us together, and we learned from each other, and I was lucky to be with them. I learned so much from them. They paid for dance classes and acting classes, and I'm so lucky. It was music theater workshop, and I was so lucky to be a part of that company. I was with them throughout high school, and because of them, I had so many other opportunities. I worked with Steppenwolf for a long time, and it was because of them as well. Yeah, so I worked with Steppenwolf back home, and there I did straight shows, and but they wrote in some singing parts for me. Yeah, and I'd love to work with them again, you know. But here in New York, I'm currently working on a workshop for something at the Kennedy Center that it was supposed to open in April, but now it's been postponed. But yeah, it's a wonderful company. Yeah, very talented artists.
So you started doing opera and you moved over to jazz. That's quite a transition. What made you make that transition?
Growing up, I always, you know, at our house, we always had Frank Sinatra, all the Rat Pack. It was a very musical home, very, very musical. But my heart I was capable of doing opera, but my heart just, it was there. I loved singing Judy Garland, and, you know, I also listened to Diana Krall, too, and Ella, well, and she's more contemporary, of course, but Ella Fitzgerald, Sarah Vaughan, all the classics, and I just noticed my voice started emulating their voices, and I was happier. My heart, you know, they're crooners, and they just speak. They don't even sing. They just speak the words, and that's what I wanted to do.
Wow, quite a career moving to New York 6 years ago and working like mad. Anyway, let's do this. Let's go check out a clip from Mary, and then we'll come back here to the studio with her and interview her some more. Okay, check this out. That was Mary Aldousary. Boy, that was beautiful. What a voice you have. It's incredible. Now, Mary, tell us about some of your upcoming projects. I hear you do quite a little bit of La Mancha. Tell us a little bit about that.
It'll be the show that I'm going to do for the rest of my life, and I hope it speaks to me. I feel like I've lived the show, and it works for my type as well and my voice. I just got cast in another production in Chicago, so I'll be there for the summer. And it's another amazing production. I can't wait to be a part of it. I feel like even though I've done it before, it's so new to me. I could sing the pieces over and over. I could cry every single day just naturally because it's like the first time I've ever heard it.
So now, you obviously, when you do a show that often, as is the case with a lot of artists, they just go from the same show to a different company and a different company. You must love the show. Are there any other musicals or other plays that you love to do that you've done repeatedly, or is Men of La Mancha it?
At this point, I think Men of La Mancha is it. I mean, I'm still young. I'm even too young for the characters. So hopefully I'll do it until I think when I really develop into the characters in my 30s and 40s, not quite there. I can't wait to be there. So then I can really book every Aldonza part anywhere, hopefully. But I would love to do West Side Story. I would love, oh, My heart is in it. I would love to do West Side Story. So there are other shows that I'm dying to do. In the Heights. Oh my gosh, I would love to be in the Heights. But I think with my look and my type and my voice, there aren't as many options right now for me. I have an older voice and a younger look. So, you know, unless they write something for me, then maybe I'll be able to work more. But right now it's tough though, because you can't quite tell what I am too. And so once I break the barrier, hopefully, you know, when I break the mold for certain characters, then I'll hopefully be working more too as well.
That happened to me. They didn't know if I was a man or a woman. No, I'm just kidding. They didn't know if I was Greek, Jewish, Italian, Hispanic. They didn't know where to put me, you know? But Fernandez gave it away. Anyway, any last remark to our audience here that is getting to know you for the first time, I think, here in Jersey and in New York and all over the world? Because our friend Jay, the co-producer over there with the other crazy producer, they even have the show now on the internet, you know, flying to Mexico and all kinds of places. So you're going to be seen anywhere. Any arriba for the Mexicans or anything like that?
Hard work pays off. I recently read Malcolm Gladwell's Outliers, and it talks about putting your 10,000 hours in. And you know what? Everyone that I feel like is successful, it's either luck or hard work, but it's both. It is both. I just, if you know you want it, go for it. Work your butt off if you have to. We all do. We all do to get where we need to be. So just hard work pays off.
Well said. Anyway, let's get back to me in the studio. Mary Aldousary, thank you for being here on Live on Stage. Mary, it's a pleasure having you. Yeah, baby. I'm feeling cool today. Feeling cool. Anyway, we're back to me here in the studio and Live on Stage. Lucio Fernandez, luciofernandez.com, luciocuba.com, thecubankid.com. That's .com for you people don't speak bilingual like me. Bilingual. Hey, cameraman, come closer, baby. Feel the love. Feel the love. Siente el amor de la cámara. Aquí cerquita, cerquita. It's my show, baby. You got to feel me. Anyway, what do you guys think about the show? Mary Aldousary singing. Larry, Megan, Amy. Everybody's rocking and rolling here live on stage. Everybody's calling me. They want to be interviewed. The shows that are coming your way, people, are stupendous. That's why I got glasses, because I'm becoming a big celebrity. Finally. Maybe I'll make the big bucket soon. The big bucket. You hear what I'm saying? Big buckets. Okay, I'm going. They're cutting me off. I gotta go. The show's gotta go. Nos tenemos que ir. Chequeme toda la semana aquí en Live on Stage. Online. LiveOnStageTV.com. LucioFriends.com. TheCubanKid.com. LucioCuba.com. Nos vemos. Till next time, I am your host, Lucio Fernandez. Good night, everybody. Come closer, baby. Feel the love.